Yes, children, nice to see you all in the video. Now I am going to explain you the poem of a fourth unit. Okay, so what is our poem? It's the last bargain. It's the last bargain, poem number 4 in our English textbook. Here, this poem, what does it tell is, what is the life of a man? Man wants freedom. Okay. Here, more than wealth, more than properties, more than assets, he wants his peaceful life. His life wants to be peaceful. So here, I'll just tell you one thing. Here, the outline of the summary of the poem is nothing but simple. Man searches for a job. Okay, he wants such a job that which gives him peace of mind. Okay. So, what is the job here? What does he do? Here, what is the title of the poem? The Last Bargain. What is the title? The Last Bargain. Bargain means what? Bargain means is nothing but an agreement between two parties. They agree to do something for each other. Okay. So, bargain is which in which both the parties promise to do something for each other. So if you do something to your friend and your friend will do something to you in that place. Okay, so a job in such a way that gives peace of mind, a help to each other. Okay, a bargain is nothing but an agreement between two parties which who promise to do something for each other. For example, take your friend, you are good in art. Okay, so you are good in art and you are lazy in writing. You don't complete your notes on time. Okay, then your friend is good in writing. She is lazy to do art. Okay, so your friend says to you, hey, please write. What she says, you are good in art, na? Please draw me some diagrams. I'll complete your notes and give. Isn't it? So you draw diagrams for her and she will complete your notes for you. Isn't it? So it is an agreement in which both the parties help each other to do some work. Okay, so if you do something, you will be giving something. Okay, so you do to her and he will do to you. Or you do to him, he will do to you. Or you will do to her and she will do something to you. So like that, here one person wants a job. He wants to hire a job. Okay, so he wants a job. So if anybody hires him, he sees what will be the result. I mean, what amount they are giving, what is they are giving. So what they are giving, who is giving, what they are giving, what is this, everything clumsy, isn't it? Yeah. Just I'll tell you the outline. Here one man searches for a job. He is in need of a job. So he goes early in the morning, everywhere in the streets. When he was going walking on the road, he sees one king. A king calls him and tells him, I will hire you and I'll give you the power. I will hire you and give you the power. That means I'll give you the work. If you do my work, I will give you the power. If you do my work, I will give you the power. Power, what he will do with the power? Power means what? Authority. He can control someone. He can become the king. He can become the leader for some area, for some group. So like that power I will give, he says. Then he thinks, he ponders, what will I do with the power? What is the use of power? Power will be only for some days. Ruling can be only for few years or few days, few months. But after that, authority will go away to some other person. So what is the use of power? So he rejects the king's offer and he goes away. Okay. While walking, again in the afternoon, it will be a mid-afternoon. The roads will be very hot. The streets will be very hot. Okay. So, the roads will be hot, streets will be hot, all the doors will be closed. No one will be there outside. it will be hot summer, midday, noon. So what happens while walking, he just tells, I am ready to hire, is anyone there to hire me. He'll be just crying, means not crying, tears, he'll be shouting, he will be calling, yelling. Then one man, old man, opens the door and comes out and says, that old man says, I will hire you for gold coins. He'll have bag full of gold coins and he'll say, I will hire you for gold coins. Will you do work for me? I will give you gold coins. Then this man will again think, he will ponder, gold coins? What will I do with these gold coins? What is the use of gold? If I take gold with me, my life will be in danger. Anybody may kill me and take away that gold. I don't have peace of mind. Every time I must keep it safely. What will I do with this much of gold? This gold is of no use. So, what he will think is, no, he rejects that old man's offer also. He says, no, I don't have use of this gold. I can't do anything with this gold. So he rejects the old man's offer and he walks. Walking. It becomes evening. And in the evening, he comes over across the one garden. In that garden, one beautiful girl will be standing. There will be good, beautiful flowers in the garden, full of blossomed. So when that girl was standing there, she smiles and she calls this man and says, hey, I want to hire you with my smiles. She says that, you do me the work and I'll be smiling for you. You do me the work and I will be smiling for you. Then, after some time, he will think, what I'll do with her smiles? If she laughs for me, if she smiles for me, what I'll get? It's nothing. I'm not connected with that. What the smiles will help me in my life? And within the meantime, that smiles will not be forever. Sometimes she may be in tears. Tears may come. Every time you always will not be in the happiness, isn't it? Sometimes sorrows also come. Sometimes happiness also comes. A person will get both sorrows and happiness, good things and bad things in his life. Okay, every time he can't be happy and every time he can't be crying. Some days good will be there, some days bad will be there. Okay, so every time she can't be smiling for me, isn't it? And what will I do with her smiles? She may get tears also. He will think like that, and in the meantime, the girl will be in tears and she will go away back into her garden. Then again walking, he reaches a beach. When he reaches a beach, there he sees one small boy playing with the shells, mud and shells. Okay, so what he will do is, the boy sees at this man and smiles. As if the boy knows this man, he smiles at that man. Then this man will go to the boy. And the boy says, I will hire you, but I don't have anything to give you. If you play, that means, if you play with me, I'll feel very happy, but I don't have anything to give you. I want you to play with me. Will you play with me? The boy will says. Then the man feels very happy and says that, yes, I'll play with you, he says. And he starts playing with that boy. The boy also feels happy. This man also feels happy. This man gets peace of mind. Why? Because he selected the work which he gets a peace of mind. What is the work? What was the first work he rejected? The power. The king wants to give the power to this man, but he rejected. Second, the rich man wants to give gold for him. If you do me the work, I will give you gold, he says. The rich man says that he will give gold. He rejected that gold also. The third one, the girl asked, I will smile for you. If you do me the work, if you do the work for me, I will be going on smiling for you. Then what is the use of smiling? He rejects that one also. And last, fourth one, the small boy, what he does is, he says that, I don't have anything to give you. If you play with me, I feel very happy. Then that he accepts the offer of the small boy and he wants the boy to make happy. So he plays with that boy. So the last bargain, what was the last bargain he accepted? Playing with a boy. The boy will be playing with the shells near the sea. Okay. He accepts that boy's bargain. I mean, he accepts that boy's offer and he starts playing with him. Why did he select that boy's offer? Because he wants to give peace. He wants to be in peace and he wants to make others happy. He wants to make others happy. Children, nowadays, wealth is not important, gold is not important, luxury life, cars, buildings, bungalows, these are not important. Peace of mind is important. What is important? Peace of mind. When we have peace of mind only, we can work full-fledgedly. We can work happily. When there is no peace of mind, we can't work. Either no person can work. For example, take your father or mother. If they are given burden with work continuously, can they work? No, they fall sick. So, every man, what he wants is peace of mind. Some people are there, they want only money, they want only wealth. That wealth will not be ever for us. That wealth will not be with us forever. What will we do if we have, now for example, take corona. Lot of people are suffering from corona. Though they have lot of assets, they have bungalows, cars and all. What is important for them now? Life is important. They are in danger. They are in danger position. Will car help them? Will bungalow help them? Is money helping them? Nothing will help them. Only peace of mind, good health, others' happiness. If we make others happy, God will make us happy. If we make others sad, if we hurt others, God will make us sad. Okay, so what this man chose is, he doesn't want wealth, he don't want power, he don't want gold, he don't want smiles or anything. He want only peace of mind. That peace of mind, where did he find? He found near that boy. So, what is the poem saying is, what is the poem saying about is, we should make others happy. Simplicity, goodwill, honesty, peace of mind, these bring a good nature for a person. These things bring a good nature for a person. Not the wealth, not the material wealth, not the properties. Okay, children? I think you have understood the moral. Okay, so he selected the job which gives him peace of mind. So I think you have understood the outline of the poem. Now in detail, I'll explain you in the next video the poem with summaries. Okay, children, bye.